In the last video, we talked at length about adding new versions. So what I'd like to do right now is just kind of go over how to look at the different versions. And first of all, let me go ahead and start by creating a new version of this tank over here. I've got a storage tank, and let's pretend that we've got a new product that we're going to put in as of today. So what I'll do is I'll first create a new version. So I'll choose Create Version. It's going to have this effective date. Actually, before I do that, let's just look at before and after. Here we go. We've got version 1, revision 1. So we haven't really made any significant changes here. I'll go into storage tank, right click, create a version. As of right now, that's going to be the current time. Of course, you can browse for a time as well. You can add a comment. Now we've got a new version. So this version would be presumably something that has something significantly different. So let's say you've changed from one product to this product right here. We'll go ahead and store that in. And the way to verify that this has now been stored in two different places, you know, as both the original and the new version, is to go into this tab here called Version, and you can see the option here called Show History. Now, I actually could see from the user interface over here that there was some history to show. So you look at the little icon there, now it has a little clock on it. The little clock indicates that we've got more than one version of this element. So if I choose Show History, we can see all the different versions. And if I select this, take a look at the product, it's HC1500. Take a look at the previous one, it's BCS1700. By the way, anybody want to guess what January 1st, 1970 at midnight stands for? Well, that's kind of the zero time mark for Pi systems. It's basically since the beginning of when we were counting time. So whenever you see this January 1st, 1970, it basically means that nobody has made any changes to this, and that's just the original effective date. So from the beginning of Pi time up until this point in time right there, then the product was BCS1717. Once we got to that version, the product had changed. Now, if you've got, you know, you may look at this and say, hey, hold on a second, I've got dozens and dozens of attributes. Do I have to look through the whole thing and compare like that? Well, no, if you hold down Control and select both of them at once, what you'll see is we will highlight where there is a product, where there is a change. So in this case, we say product value, and then we say it was this. So we're highlighting what the differences are between the two versions right there. I'd like to point out that, of course, it's going to show changes going back historically to all of these items, except, of course, if you've got references to Pi tags. Remember, that's the value of a Pi tag. If we make a change to that, that's not something that's going to be stored with the version. But if you notice, this right here, this product, that's not a configuration item like these are. These indicates, you know, these will increment the revision. This is not a configuration item, but it's still an attribute of that AF element. So we do historize that. And of course, we will historize these as well. So let's say, for example, we change the height, kind of far-fetched, but let's say this is now, we realize that's 9 meters. Go ahead and check this in. See, that's something else that when we take a look at the different revisions by showing the history, we'll see that show up as well. So I'll go ahead and select the two. And so at every instance in which there's a difference, you're going to see that highlighted. So the value is now 9, value was 10, etc., and the product change as well. So as you can see, we're historizing that through this versions mechanism. Now, if at some point you decide that you've got an element that really is no longer going to be useful to people, in other words, it's obsolete, you can simply specify an obsolete date. And then as long as your query date is before that obsolete date, you will see the value. Once the query date is after the obsolete date, then at that point, we won't see it anymore. It just simply doesn't appear in the AF search results. So for example, I'm going to say back on the 1st of October, that was the obsolete date for this particular AF element here. Once I go ahead and check that in, well, if you notice, we don't see it anymore. And the reason we don't see it is because our query date is taking the default, which is the current time. So we've effectively made that disappear from any of the AF clients that would be searching for or displaying that AF element. Now, to go back and look at that again, we'd have to change the query date. We're going to do that in the next video.